that's that money talk. That's that money talk. Got a lot of fans, a lot of haters, we just let them talk. Cause them never faces to the paper. What you talking about? The earth will really shake it with this craters that we throwing out, yeah. Came up in the game and gave it mouth to mouth.
Take some more. You got titty freedom. Block his number. And I will epic kill him, I promise.
What is up, you guys? It's your boy T-Russ back with another video. And you see what we repping. We repping that number 4 Dak Prescott Dallas Cowboys. Let's get it. So, I didn't want to do this video. Because, honestly, I like Carson Wentz. Yeah, I like Carson Wentz, but he's overrated, especially to Eagles fans. He's overrated. So, it's time to crush and destroy something that people, I guess that's something that people want to see because they keep doing it to him. And the Eagles did to him by paying him what they paid him. We made a video about that. So, let's get right into it. First off, I want to say, I knew what was going to happen with Dak Prescott's contract. The Cowboys should have paid him a long time ago. Because the more they wait, the more money it gets added on to his contract. And that's okay with me. Pay that man his money. He deserves it. Pay that man his money. He deserves it. As long as we pay everybody else, pay him that money. But for the Cowboys, that's a bad thing. Because, yeah, the longer they wait, the more money he gets. Because the Russell Wilson contract gave him a little more money. The Carson Wentz contract gave him a lot more money because now he's going to be matching Carson Wentz's contract. At least it's guaranteed money. He's going to be matching that. And the next person in line is Jared Goff. And he's getting more. Jared Goff's going to get more money than Carson Wentz just because he led his team to the Super Bowl. So let's get right into it. Let's get right into it. Carson Wentz versus Dak Prescott. This is really, it's, whatever. Let's go. Alright, so, let's start with Carson Wentz. Carson Wentz is, nonetheless, injury prone. We can start with that. He's nonetheless injury prone. He's been hurt all 3 years of his career. Now, his rookie year, I don't believe he missed any games, but he did get injured. You know, he got hurt at, with North Dakota State, is that where he went? He got hurt there, too. He broke his wrist. So, you know, he's injury prone, you know, ACL injury this year and a back injury, or was it, or is it switch? No, ACL injury his second year and then back injury this year that kept him out games. And he had Nick Foles to back him up, luckily. He's never played in a playoff game, so I'm not sure that the Eagles would even have won a championship his second year if it wasn't for Nick Foles. Nick Foles led him to a championship. Not Carson Wentz. He's never played a playoff game. And then this year, and that was his best year, by the way. And then this year, he comes back. He's like, okay, I'm gonna prove what I did last year wasn't a fluke. And he starts off 5-6. He starts off 5-6 as a starter, and then Nick Foles finishes and leads his team to the playoffs. He didn't prove anything. He was 5-6. 5-6, and Nick Foles had to finish it off for him. Nick Foles had to bring him to the playoffs. He had to lead him to the playoffs, and that's exactly what Nick Foles did. He led him pretty far in the playoffs, farther than anybody thought they would get. So now we get to Dak Prescott. And by the way, right now, Carson Wentz's floor is very, very low. His ceiling may be high, but his floor is very, very low. His floor is like RG3 level low. That's how low his floor is. RG3 level low. Alright? RG3 level. And then Dak Prescott's floor. I feel like Dak Prescott's floor is Tony Romo. Statistically, the best Cowboys quarterback ever. Tony Romo. Because if you look at it, he's already matched him. Especially with playoff wins. He's got division titles. He's already matching what Tony Romo has done. So, statistically and accomplishment-wise, Dak Prescott's floor is Tony Romo. But his ceiling is very, very high. It's very, very high because he's 25 years old, has two division titles, and a playoff game win. It's very, very high. Not many players do that. All right. So Dak Prescott, best completion percentage of anybody in their first 3 years, of anybody in their first 3 years, with 66%. Carson Wentz threw 63%. Dak Prescott threw 10,876 yards on 48 games. Carson Wentz threw 10,152 on 40 games. Carson Wentz threw 70 touchdowns. Dak Prescott threw 67. We'll get into that later. Carson Wentz threw 27 interceptions. Dak Prescott threw 25. And through 48 games, Dak Prescott is 32-16. Through 40, Carson Wentz is 23-17. So through less games, he already has more losses. Carson Wentz has 542 rushing yards. Dak Prescott has 944 with 18 touchdowns to Carson Wentz's 2. So statistically, it's not even close. And Carson Wentz has them in passing touchdowns, but then you look at total touchdowns and you're like, wait a minute. Dak Prescott has 85 total touchdowns to Carson Wentz's total 72. Because Dak Prescott is a dual threat quarterback, a true dual threat quarterback. So he's not going to have more passing yards than anybody. But total touchdowns, yes sir, because he averages 22 touchdowns. Passing touchdowns and 6 rushing touchdowns a year. That's what he averages. And I believe 18 touchdowns, that's what 6 times 3? 18. So he's at 6 touchdowns each of his 3 careers. Or each of his 3 seasons. I believe one season he had 7 and another season he had 5. But he's averaging 6 touchdowns, 6 rushing touchdowns a season. And then he has 944 rushing yards. So like, Dak Prescott is a true dual-threat quarterback, so he's not going to have the best passing stats of anybody. And skill-wise, I just think Dak Prescott, he has better IQ, he has better accuracy, he's better throwing on the run, and he's getting better in that pocket. Kellen Moore said a few days ago that he's getting his deep ball accuracy is getting better and better, and especially with Michael Gallup. And I think with Michael Gallup, it had more to do with chemistry than anything else. Because sometimes it was Michael Gallup's fault where he would just stop and slow down and Dak would sling that ball expecting him to go get it. So yeah, that was just chemistry, which was going to come, and now it's here. And so Dak Prescott, he's that guy. So him improving on his deep throw accuracy reduces any flaw he has in his game. And then if he gets the ball out quicker, the only thing he would have to improve on really is accuracy. And we already said he's the most accurate quarterback of any quarterback in the of all time in their first 3 years. So that's crazy. That's crazy. Dak Prescott, he's a beast. Like, I don't think people understand. And then their head-to-head matchups, Dak Prescott is 4-2. One of those losses coming on a 12-2 season where he didn't even play the last game against the Eagles. So it's really 4-1. It's really 4-1. So, like I said, Dak Prescott, he's a monster. He's a monster. It's 4-2. I don't think they... Is it 4-2? I don't know. It's either 4-1 or 4-2. It's one of those. I think it's 4-2 because if you add up, yeah, that's 6 games. 4-2. Yeah, they're 4-2. So, yeah. Dak Prescott is a beast. So, I mean, what else? He's got the wins. He's got the stats. Oh, game-winning drives. Dak's 14 to Carson Wentz's 4. He's got the clutchness. If any quarterback in the league, I want it in Dak Prescott's hands. That's why I was disappointed that the defense against the Rams could not get a stop. Because Dak, when you give Dak Prescott the ball, he's scoring. And we're going to overtime, and we're winning that game. And I say that with the utmost confidence in my quarterback. Because he's done it several times. He's done it several times. And then we go to toughness. Dak Prescott, he was hurt earlier this year against the Redskins. You could see it in his eyes. It looked like he had a concussion. But nonetheless, I believe he only missed one or two plays. And he was back out there. Ultimately, we lost the game, but Dak Prescott still played it out. And that just shows how tough this guy is. And then, have you ever heard any problems with Dak Prescott and his leadership? Because I believe just 4 months ago, there were inside sources that were saying Carson Wentz was not a leader and he was selfish. And I was like, well then. So, you know, Dak Prescott is a better quarterback. And then I can bring this up, but it really doesn't matter. Carson Wentz, he's the second overall pick, and he's not living up to it. You know, they traded 4 picks for that man. Dak Prescott is a 4th-round overall pick. Come on, man. His first season, he led us to the playoffs, 13-3. Come on, bro. That's crazy. And Carson Wentz lives in Nick Foles' shadow because Nick Foles bought him a championship while he was hurt. Dak Prescott lives in Tony Romo's shadow, and he's already surpassed that. He already got his playoff win. He's matched everything that Tony Romo has did. Tony Romo, he really hasn't done anything in his career as far as winning in the playoffs goes. Dak Prescott has already matched that. So, I mean, to me, there is no debate, but I guess this is what Eagles fans wanted. This is what Dak Prescott fans or Dak Prescott haters wanted. So I brought it to you. And there you go. Dak Prescott, you know, the facts are there. It's right in front of your face. Dak Prescott is a very quarterback to Carson Wentz. And he statistically doesn't win anywhere. He doesn't win in any category. And then their passing rating. Over the last 3 years, Dax is 95, Carson Wentz is 92. You could go anywhere, and he just doesn't win. He has more losses, less wins. I mean, what else? What else do you want me to bring up? Like, it's simple. They want to, Carson Wentz fans want to bring up his Super Bowl ring, but like, really? He hasn't even played a playoff game. You want to bring up a Super Bowl ring, bro? That's crazy. Like, Dak Prescott could do what Carson Wentz did in the playoffs in his Super Bowl year. Like, come on now. So, anyway, that's it for this video. Make sure y'all smash that like button, comment, subscribe, and share with everybody you know. I see you for now, so peace.
Fuck with me, you lucky bitch. All I get is money, bitch. Run it up, I'm dummy rich. Y'all be on that funny shit. Y'all see who I'm coming with? Fuck you and your slutty bitch. Wanna be my buddy, bitch. You can't be my buddy, bitch.